back to Angie's Creative Studio. Today I am going to do a short watercolor landscape, I think. And I'm going to use... Don't pay no attention to my washi tape. I'm just going to draw a few lines and some mountains and... on here, and then I'm going to draw a few rocks. And that's about all I'm going to do with this. And I am using a number 16 round, use what you have. And I wish I would have got me another. Hang on. Okay. Now, I am just using a glass palette. And I am going in with ultramarine and blue. I am using the Cotton watercolors from Winslow and Newton, and I am just going in and with this big old round, and I am just going to do my sky, just, and I'm just going to let myself run out of paint. Closer I get to the mountains, and if I go over the mountains, ain't no big deal because it will cover, I think. Now I'm going down here and do the same identical. And do the same thing. This is just my base coat. And I am working in a Master Touch water journal. Watercolor. And this seems to be better than the pads and stuff that you buy normally. Well, it seems to be. I mean, take it with a grain of salt. Probably use on paper. Anything. And I may say, and then try something different. And I'm like, oh, yeah, this looks good. And I'm just going to go up here and just kind of darken this, but I'm going to thin it out. I'm going to have to get that out. I'm going to have to make y'all this to me. Sorry about that. Was it? I just threw this video on at the last minute. And I'm just going to take just a wet brush and just kind of brush it out. And this is just 8.5 by 5.5. Okay, I am taking some burnt sienna. And I'm just going to make another paw on my plate. And then I'm just going to mix this all up together. I'm wanting a gray. I'm going to put some blue. Yeah. There we go. And if I use it all, no big deal. What I do, I just let it dry, usually in those plants, and sometimes I go back and use them. Or if it's just a little bit, I'll just clean it and move. Okay, now I'm going to take some more of this ultramarine and blue. Man, I can't even talk. And some Olympsum crit. And I'm just going to make just a very light. I'm just going back over my mountains. I'm just going to take this black sienna, and I'm just going to just lightly do my rocks. Now this ain't all I'm doing to them, so just know that. Okay, now I'm going to work on this bottom. I'm going to paint this. This is what I like to work on the grass. I mean, it's so easy to clean up. I'm taking some of this ultramarine and blue. And I am going to take some. I'm on mix. Let's see if I can get a dog. And I am going just right underneath this, my mountain. And your mountain don't have to be in this shape. I mean, use what, you know, you can make your mountain any shape y'all want. I mean, there is no right, wrong way of doing mountains, I don't think. I'm going to do some cream here in just a few minutes. I layering my rocks. I'm using a little bit of this gray. Okay. Now I'm taking some more ultramarine blue. And some cad yellow. Brush clean. Let's see that. Okay, I'm gonna mix this, the blue, the ultramarine and the yellow to give and make a green. Okay. Now, I'm going to take the Zap Green. Y'all, this is how you want it. It's just play with your colors. And I know some people will say, no, don't mix them. Mix them. Okay, I am just going to make trees. Or I'm just making an illusion of trees on this. Now I'm just using my round brush. Okay, I am going to pause y'all and I can blow dry this. Okay, we are back. I am taking a number 8. And I'm going to mix. A little bit of the Zap Green. With ultramarine in the blue. And I'm just gonna get go in about twice with this, maybe. And then I'm just gonna go back and kind of do what I was doing before. I mean, I don't really want. I mean, this is, you know, way off, so you don't really see the shapes of the trees. But you got, you know, those trees over there. And if you're like, I am, you get here on your brush, just take it off. Don't use your brush to take it off, or otherwise you'll mess it all up. I have learned that the hard way. kept company. I'm just going in and just kind of making
Okay.
I'm going in with the beginning. Now I'm just gonna water this down. I'm just kind of mix it with your thing.
We are doing rocks. Way too much.
What do you have, Toot Toot? Happened here. I didn't even see that happen. Did y'all? Okay. Okay. Who says you can't have too many plates? I'll see. I'm just gonna go right under here. And I am using a favorite 10. I do like this favorite. It is a Roar Lineal Zine. Okay, I am going to take this little Winston and Newton. And I don't know what number this is. It's just a real fine. I mean, it's fine. Let's see it. And I'm going to work on my. And I'm going to use some quantum. Just really a dark brownish, grayish tone. head in the way again, ain't it? Solid rock. I'm just not having no luck otherwise. Sometimes you just go with the flow. Oh, I do. A lot of people don't, but I do. Okay, I'm going to pause y'all again and blow dry this and see what it looks like. Okay. The reason why I pause y'all to blow dry is because my hair dryer is just loud. I mean, it's loud. Okay, I'm going back in with some Zap Green. And my water is nasty. And some Ultramarina Blue. And I'm going back in, and I'm just giving these trees just a little bit more definition. Mostly at the bottom. And I am using the filbert for this time. They've got something underneath my desk. Okay, now, here's the fun part. We're gonna take some we're gonna see what this makes. It may make mud, I don't know. And some Zap Green. Like an olive green. Okay. I can handle that. I am going right in the middle of my lake, and I am going to do a tree. And the way I make my trees, I'm still learning, so y'all bear with me. I've got it pretty down packed with a pencil, paintbrush. I'm not for sure yet, but we're gonna try. I'm just gonna work with it until I get it. Okay, now I'm going to do just going back down, just doing like I was doing, and I'm just kind of playing with the brush, and I'm just doing this kind of like I would
the Alma Lake is the in, well, not really, but
the Alma Lake has some to do with this. If y'all want to know,
I love going to the Alma Lake and just sitting and painting or drawing. I do it both at the Alma Lake a lot. But since it's got hot, I'm not going as much. I don't do the seat good.
Okay, now I am going to take this little fine light brush. I still got mixed views on this.
And I am going to just go up here and make some grass. Some pretty green looking grass.
Yes, Tate. What have you been into?
Did you find food somewhere? Keep your breath, your oil stinks. And then I'm just gonna go just kind of lightly. And I'm starting on my paint, on my washi tape, and just making grass marks. Just short little grass marks through here. I'm just going in and just touching some of these leaves with some yellow.
Okay. Now I'm going to pull the tape off, and this is why I like to use washi tape when I'm painting, because it gives it a real pretty border around your painting, and you don't mess up the rest of the book either, like I have. And I'm going to sign my John Henry. And this is 6/9/2001. I hope y'all enjoyed this 30-minute video. Give us a thumbs up if you did. And we'll catch you later. Have a blessed day. Bye.